In this video, I'm going to show you different ways to install Flux and how to set up the right workflows for it. I will also be comparing all the Flux models and sharing my thoughts. So stick around until the end, you're definitely going to learn a lot. Alright, let's jump in. If you click on the Flux download link in the description below, it will take you to a document I have put together just for you. In there, you will find some extra information about Flux. Plus, I have also included my Patreon, where you can support me if you would like. As a thank you, you will get access to exclusive workflows for download, including the one from today's video. This will save you time since you can just download it instead of building it yourself. On top of that, you will get an upscaler, facefix, and a bunch of other tools for Flux, all included in the workflow. But let us get back to the main topic of the video. Flux is an image generation model developed by the Black Forest Labs team, who were previously developers at Stability AI. Here you can also see a few sample images that show how well Flux can generate. It is truly a significant advancement compared to older models. In the document, you can also read up on how Flux works and the differences between Flux Schnell and Flux Dev. I will not spend too much time explaining what Flux is in this video because I want to keep things short and to the point, and I am assuming most of you already know the basics. But one thing I should mention is that Flux Schnell is under the Apache 2.0 license, while Flux Dev is non-commercial. You definitely need to know this before you start using these models for your projects. I will clearly show you the difference in image quality between the two versions later in the video, but just so you know, in my opinion, the Dev model definitely produces better results than the Schnell version. Before we start with the installation, I would like to show you another option, using Flux without installing it. If your PC does not have enough resources, you can easily use Flux on Hugging Face. Just click on the arrow here and it will take you straight to the website. There, you can only use the Schnell model, but it is a good starting point. Let me quickly show you an example. You simply enter your prompt and click Generate. As you can see, a great image was created in no time. So now let us get to the actual installation. There are two methods, the easy one and the regular one. The easy method is perfect for those of you who do not have a powerful PC, as it uses fewer resources. But keep in mind that the image quality will be a bit lower. If you want to jump straight to the regular installation, just keep in mind that 32 GB of RAM is recommended. The easy installation itself is really simple. You just download the Schnell and Dev models and place them in your checkpoints folder in ComfyUI. My path might be a little different since I'm using Pinocchio, but yours should look pretty similar. Once you have done that, just start up ComfyUI and you are all set to go. The workflow you need for this is pretty basic. It is the one you start with when you first use ComfyUI. I will quickly show you how to set it up again. If there is something you do not understand or if you need more details, feel free to check out my first ComfyUI video or the entire series. That will make it easier for you to follow along with my video. You can also pause the video or rewind if something goes by too quickly. Since this is just a simple workflow, I will not be commenting on the setup as I have already built it countless times in previous videos. So, once the workflow is ready, we will start with the Schnell model. Set the steps to 4, CFG to 1, and make sure the sampler is set to Euler with the scheduler on normal. You can always check the document while working on it. I have left a few notes in there as reminders for you. Once you have got everything set, we can start the generation. And as you can see, the model has already created a nice image for us. Now, let us try some different dimensions and see what we get. That already looks a lot better. You can see that even the worst model still produces really good image quality. It is quite impressive. Now, let us switch to the Dev model. For this one, we will set the steps to 20 and start right away. And as you can see, the image this model generated is even more detailed and, in my opinion, looks more realistic. If you are enjoying the video so far, do not forget to leave a like and subscribe for more videos like this. Alright, now let us move on to the regular installation. First, head back to my document and download these two files here. Then, place them into the models folder under Clip in ComfyUI. Next, download this file and put it into your VAE folder in ComfyUI. Once that is done, you will need to download the Schnell and Dev models and place them into your unit folder in ComfyUI. I have also outlined each path in the document in case you forget where to put something. After all the downloads are finished, just head back to ComfyUI. Alright, let us get started building the normal Flux workflow. It is actually pretty easy to understand. If you are a supporter, you can just download the workflow directly from my supporter workflows. You will also get an upscaler and a facefix for Flux, like I mentioned earlier. Okay, let us come back to building the regular Flux workflow. First, we need the Load Diffusion Model node, where we will select our model. After that, we will grab the Dual Clip Loader node. Here, you will choose Flux as the type and load the two clips we downloaded earlier. Next, we will create a Load VAE node and select our VAE. Then, we need the Clip Text Encode node for our prompt. This connects to a Basic Guider. The Basic Guider connects to the Sampler Custom Advanced node, which will link everything together. Now, we will hook that up to the Random Noise node, where we can set our seed. After that, we need the Case Sampler Select node, where we choose our sampler. In this case, Euler. Next, we will create a basic scheduler node, where we set the scheduler to normal and configure the steps. For the Schnell model, set steps to 4, and for the Dev model, set steps to 20. Once that is done, we will create an empty latent image node where we can set the image size and the number of images to generate. Now we will connect everything to the VAE decode node, which links to the VAE and the preview image node. And we are almost done. I just forgot to connect the basic scheduler to the models. Once you have done that, the workflow is complete and we are ready to go. I will also be explaining all the nodes in detail in my ComfyUI doc in the future for those of you who want to dive deeper into the topic. First, I'm going to generate with the Schnell model. It takes a bit of time to load at the start, so make sure to plan for a few minutes. Once it is fully loaded and generated, you can see the result here. I have to say, the Schnell model performs much better than in the simple installation. The quality is definitely an improvement. Now let us try it with the Dev model. After generating with that, you can see the results and they look really good. Honestly, I am amazed by the quality this model delivers. The realism is definitely a step up compared to the older stability models. Now let me show you a comparison between the two models and the different installation methods. Alright, here we have four preview nodes. At the top, we have the Schnell models and at the bottom, the Dev models. They are arranged from left to right based on their downloads. The first one is the FP8 version of the models, which we used in the simple installation, and the second row shows the FP16 version, which we used in the regular installation. You can already see the best comparison here. I have used the same seed and prompt for all of them, and this is what came out, as you can see. You can definitely tell that Dev creates much more realistic images with more detail compared to Schnell. Also, the FP8 versions of both models show a slight drop in quality compared to the FP16 versions. Here is another example with images where text was supposed to be generated. All the models handled the text pretty well, but again, you can clearly see the difference in detail and quality between them. Schnell can still generate photorealistic images like the ones you see here, but you might need to tweak the prompt a bit more to get there. With the Dev model, it happens automatically, probably because it has been trained more for that. I will show you another example, this time with a small Italian town. Honestly, the quality improvements are pretty minimal. It really comes down to what kind of images you want to generate. If a slight drop in quality doesn't make a big difference for you, then it probably doesn't matter which model you use if it comes to landscapes. But if you want to create a photorealistic human, it is better to use the Dev model, because in my opinion, it just creates better realistic images. I recommend testing it out on your own images and deciding which model works best for you. And of course, keep an eye on how many resources each one uses. And with that, we are coming to the end of the video. If you haven't checked out my previous ComfyUI videos yet, feel free to take a look at my playlist or my latest video. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you next time.